station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Kayla LaFrance. There were a lot of firsts happening on board the station. Canadian astronaut David St. Jacques took the station's newest robotic flyer, Astrobee, on its maiden voyage. Astrobee demonstrated its ability to navigate around the station while St. Jacques put it through its basic checkout activities, testing its mobility, cameras, and controls. Astrobee uses electric fans as a propulsion system to fly freely through the microgravity environment of the station. It uses cameras and sensors to help it see and navigate its surroundings. Robots such as Astrobee will play a significant part in NASA's mission to return to the moon, as they service future spacecraft and work to monitor and keep systems operating smoothly while crews are away. A nanosat is a miniaturized satellite no bigger than the size of a shoebox and weighing less than 10 kilograms, or 22 pounds. This week, the station crew released four of these cube-shaped satellites into low Earth orbit, each one representing a different country. The satellites came from Singapore, Japan, Sri Lanka, and Nepal. For Sri Lanka and Nepal, this was a monumental moment, for these nanosats were their first ever satellites to go into space, bringing both Sri Lanka and Nepal into the space era and offering new research opportunities for their scientists and engineers. This week's question comes from Stephen Brody, who asked, if it is true that just about any area of study, psychology, research, medicine, can be a pathway to a space career. Thousands of people work for NASA. Of these people, a vast majority of them work in a wide variety of STEM fields, working on research in astronomy, geology, aviation, medicine, and space studies, just to name a few. However, not all NASA employees are scientists and engineers. NASA also offers opportunities for individuals with backgrounds in public relations, education, accounting, facility management, history, photography, and much more. The key is to find the career that you love and follow that passion, and it may lead you on a fulfilling space career. Keep sending your questions using the hashtag AskNASA. We'll see you next week.